Today we will focus on modifying crystal reports. Many of the Lucity modules have a one-line list or summary type report. There should also be a detail report. These reports are provided to be used as is, or better yet, they can be used as a jumping off point to modify them to be more useful for your agency. Crystal Reports is the software that is used to create and run the reports in Lucity. In desktop reports, they will only support functionality of Crystal 11, and web reports will support the functionality of Crystal 2008. You can use newer versions of the Crystal Reports software to create or modify reports, but any new features will not display when the reports are run in Lucity. To modify the reports, the user must have the Crystal Reports software on their computer. From here, you can create new reports or open existing ones. To find the name and location of standard reports that you may wish to modify, you open the Report dialog box and select a report. We're going to work on the summary of requests. When you click on the report, it shows up down in the report file path where it is actually located. On my computer, it's the C drive, Lucity 14R2 reports work. This actual report is the recsum.rpt report file. When a standard report is modified, it should never be saved with a standard report name, that recsum portion, because when Lucity provides an update, the Lucity standard report will replace your modified version of the report. If you wish to work on a report and run it outside of the Lucity module, then the report will need to be pointed to your data. Exporting a report is the easiest method to accomplish this requirement. I will export the summary of request report and save it with a new name. So you click on the report, select all records, say export report. For format, to Crystal Reports, destination, disk file, OK. Now you need to go to the report location where it is to be saved. And on mine, it's the C14R2 reports work. So I'm in the right location. And then down here is where you're going to give it a new file name. Give it something that makes sense. If you're going to modify a standard report slightly, you might want to leave the beginning portion the same and then just add your agency name or your initials at the end of it, and then select Save. At this point, the report has to run. So whether it be giving it date fields or category, whatever it takes to get the report to run, put something in there and push OK. Do not push Cancel, that will stop the export. Go out to the newly created report, and there it is, RecSum Lucity. It automatically opens in the preview mode because when the report is exported, it saves data with the report. So in the toolbar, click File, and then uncheck the Save Data with Report, and then Save. You now have a standard report to make revisions on that has its own unique name, recsum_lucity.rpt. To modify this report, click on the Design tab. This is where you typically make the changes. I'm going to change the priority column to show category, and then I'm going to add a new column for the assigned crew. In the request module, that's the category and the assigned crew. In the report, column headers are typically text objects. Double-click in the priority box. You can click and drag over the words and then type whatever you want to change it to. Click out of it and it's captured what you've typed in. The fields being used in the report are in this details section. Crystal requires that you have 5 portions. There has to be a report header, page header, details, report footer, and page footer. I keep them reduced into an abbreviation so that there's more room to work on the report. The priority field needs to be removed. You can right-click and say delete. And now we need to bring in the category field. To add fields, you need to know the name of the field that you want to use, and this can be found easily out in the module. If you control, right-click, Field Definition, it tells you the table name, WKREC, and the field name, RQ_CAT_TIE. You need both those pieces of information to bring the field in correctly. And while we're here, we'll go ahead and look at assigned crew. I'm going to go into the code field this time because there's another option here, field properties. It too gives you the field name, table name, but it also tells you the type of field this is, in that it could be a string or a number and the size of your field. To bring in the field, you need to have Field Explorer on. If it's the first time you're opening Crystal, it's possible that this won't be open. It would look something like this. To bring this in, you can click on the Field Explorer icon, or you can bring it in from View to open it. Then open Database Fields, and that shows you the tables that are currently associated with this report. Other tables can be added if needed. If a report is to be used with a filter, then any table used in the filter needs to be in the report. Even if the report doesn't use fields from the table in the report, the table still needs to be a part of the report. I'm going to open the WKREC table because that's where category and crew are located. You can tell which fields are being used already in the report with the check marks next to these. We're going to find the category field. You can click and drag it into the report, into the details section. I'm going to put a marker in the ruler next to category. Anytime something's attached to a marker, it turns red. That way, I can align the field under the column heading. The category field is currently overlapping this problem field. So to resize it, click on the field. It's activated. If you put your cursor on the little dot at the end, it's a sizing bar. You can click and drag it to the size that you wish. Then to align the category or any fields in here, you can click on the field, shift, right click to what you want to align with, tops or bottoms. To add a column into this report, one or more fields will either need to be removed or resized. The problem will be resized and the address moved to fit in the crew column. Clicking on problem, shift, and the field, and I'm going to resize it. I'm going to put a marker on address and move it. And then to bring in a column header, I'm going to insert a text object. Clicking on the Insert Text Object icon up here, it turns into a plus sign, and then I'm going to click where I want it located. It's now active to type in whatever I would like it to say. Click out of the box, and you have the new column header. I'm going to go ahead and resize it, even though this is empty over here and really won't affect anything. It's just on future modifications. You might grab the wrong thing and move it. So anyway, I'm going to shorten it. It comes in bold because that is the way my default is set up. Formatting can be changed by either clicking on the text box and saying Format Text, Font, and changing this bold to regular. OK, to save the change. And it now looks like the other column headers. You could also have clicked on this and used the toolbar above and change it bold, unbold. There's formatting in the toolbar. Default settings are set up in Options. So up here in the toolbar, you click File, Options. The Layout tab has rulers, guidelines, tooltips. This is where you can turn them on and off for either design or preview mode. Database tab gives you an option to sort your fields alphabetically. I would recommend that for a new user. An important setting in here is synonyms. Make sure that's turned on. If you are creating a water report and you need to bring in the work order table to have access to that, you should have synonyms on. In the reporting tab, make sure save data with report is not turned on. Under fields, you can set up various default settings for number. If you go into here for customize, You can increase the digits, decrease, and your rounding. Make sure allow field clipping is not turned on. Anytime you make a change, you want to say OK for it to save it. Here in the Fonts tab for fields, this is the way fields from your tables will be brought in. Right now they come in as regular and size 9. And then the text object, which is what we just typed in for crew, all of those come in as bold 9. And this is just a general default of what comes in, and then you can change it field by field to whatever you want it to be. We'll now bring in the crew field. And resize. And save the report. And then to use it in work request, you need to open your report dialog. It will have to be added. Even though it's out in your work folder, it's not here to be used yet. So you need to push add, browse out to the location, find your report, report name, call it something so you understand what kind of report you're opening up. You might give it some description as to maybe the changes that you made to the standard report, and save. And then it'll be in here, request summary modified. That's the report we just created. One more item I wanted to point out was on the detail reports. When you export a detail report, instead of selecting on all records, use this record only. And when you do that, it actually brings in a formula and captures the ID of the record you're on. You need to delete this. And that will then will run on all your records. Some more items. This has various detail sections, A, B, C. You can remove whole sections by right-clicking in the margin and saying delete section. You can also divide sections. I'm going to put request number up in its own section. I'm put it on the ruler. It's turned into a line with two arrows. If I click and pull off of the ruler, it's divided this section. I'm going to bring the request section up under the request number section by clicking. It turns into a hand and I can drag it up under it. And you can add new sections. Another option, you right click in the margin and say insert section below. And then you can click and drag to open this up to bring in fields or subreports. These are just a few of the easier modifications you can do to the report. Additional report help guides are located through our support website, and we will also offer crystal report training classes.